10 seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining.
All the other games are definitely going to be wet and frosty, isn't it?
Probably.
Closest to that one, but that's how you start the game.
Turn to ban.
Ah. Don't heal, cast.
Hello, ladies and gentlemen, welcome back. More action here at the TI6 group stage. We've got Team Secret going up against eHome for the second time. Game one was a long one, about 60 minutes long. At the end of the day, eHome were able to take it. Secret just unable to find that final push that they needed to turn the game around, and it would have been quite a turnaround as well. They were about 30-40k behind at the end of the game. Elder Titan, in my eyes, is a hero, and that was ridiculous how well that hero could hold back a push from a team that was 40k ahead of you.
Yeah, it's no joke, honestly. The high ground defense that Team Secret pitted against eHome, being in a excess of a 35,000 gold lead
at that point. I think the last push,
the experience might have even been more so. It was pretty ridiculous that they managed to hang out as long as they did. And that's just owed to, obviously, their draft was very good during the late game. The problem was they got too far behind too fast. And let's just give a shout out to Old 11. Because that guy and his Night Stalker,
dude, yeah, he was 20-minute Axe, or 20-minute Axe Midas.
Yeah, he was just unbelievably farmed, just took all the map control away from Secret, and it was just so difficult for them to claw their way back into the game after that point. But we are in game two. eHome this time are going to get their hands on the Coddle. This was banned first phase in the first game by Secret.
Oh, man. And if there's, well, obviously they've got the Conqueror as well, and if there's at least another hero that's just so good at allowing to sit outside the base, push in and get out, push in and get out, both of these heroes are essentially Mr. Rinse and Repeat themselves.
Yeah, no kidding.
Bam, 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 in and out, the heals are there, the sustain is real. But we'll certainly see if Secret have something to say about that. And I'm sure Secret are just going to want to make sure that they do a little bit better in the laning stage to make sure the game doesn't get to the point where they're kind of a fair bit behind.
To be honest, I think a large reason why Old 11 was able to get away with as much as he did is because they had Elder Titan Shadow Demon supports.
Yeah.
Like, they're just not good at zoning out a hero, and unless you have something else with very high kill potential, like a Juggernaut or anything that does high damage like Ursa in the laning phase, yeah, the Night Stalker is going to farm, for sure. And they also try to prioritize ganking Old 11 at some point, but they only killed him, I think, like once or twice in the first 15 or 20 minutes, and then after that point, like you mentioned, he already had his Midas and the Aghanims anyway post 20, so it didn't even matter at that point. You the hero is already pretty much at full effectiveness, and his itemization after that, he went Lotus, which was a great choice. Remaining. And after that, Secret just no map control, can't win. Tough game.
And it did feel like, as well, it was an interesting game for eHome, because they have Fenrir on the Warlock.
Yep.
And it didn't feel like he really needed to do much.
Not really.
It was there as well. At the end, he did have Refresher Ags. I mean, there were obviously a few ults that did, you know, help out in the team fights, but it never felt like eHome were reliant on that Warlock ult. There was countless times where I was like, they've got the ult, and then a fight would happen, they'd win the fight, they didn't use the ult.
And then he
still got the ult.
Yeah, it's very true.
It was a chill game for Fenrir.
But it's some comparisons can be made to, like, Enigma, for example. It's not the black hole necessarily, it's the fact that it can happen that makes people a little bit more squeamish about going in. You know, the fight bottom where they were at the tier 2 and they drop a Warlock Golem and he fatal bonds onto Sam, and then all of a sudden he can't ever go in again. You know, it's just stuff like that that makes it super annoying, and you have to play around it. You don't have a choice. So in that regard, I think the eHome are one of the better teams at making the hero work for them. And I don't have any doubt in my mind that we will see it from them in the future. But Secret, I like their opening here. I think the Lifestealer is very good against Kunkka and Keeper of the Light for obvious reasons. Like, Coddle has nothing against Rage. Neither does Kunkka. They're both very spell-based heroes. They need to be able to X-Torrent to get that kill. You need Mana Leak and Illuminate to be able to get the usefulness out of the Coddle. And Lifestealer just doesn't really care about either of them.
TA ban. Now that is an interesting one.
They could have something in mind for their mid that just isn't very good against TA. And the other part too is having a TA after seeing a Lifestealer safe lane. So a little bit of a today I learned for people who don't play much Lifestealer. Hero really sucks at killing Roshan. Like, really sucks. And then you have a Shadow Demon who's not necessarily the best pairing with a Lifestealer in general. So they're banning out mid heroes that have high physical damage output that can allow Secret to kill Roshan. Because TA is probably like the de facto Roshan killer for Direcide. It's just what you get. It's either that or like, you know, a Lycan from a team like Liquid or an Ursa, stuff like that. And I mean, Secret have run Ursa before, but I'm not entirely sure that they would draft it when they already have a Lifestealer out.
It's going to be interesting to see what else Secret target with the bans. And obviously,
well, they're trying to give Lifestealer a decent game. You know, they took out AM, who matches up very well against Lifestealer. Naga was banned in the first two. Mirana's banned out.
What about the Juggernaut? I mean, Ice Jug was absolutely terrifying.
It was very, very good. I just think that Juggernaut is not quite as good against Lifestealer. I would prefer to see something like an Ursa, personally. Because Ursa just demolishes Lifestealer, and Void is
there
good
you go.
Too. Yeah,
yeah
Void, Void is very good too.
Absolutely, another hero that Lifestealer has issues with. That's for sure.
I mean, I'm not sure if Ehome are Lycan pickers or Ursa pickers, but they're both great against Lifestealer. And at this point, Team Secret have virtually no control. And there's also the argument that Elder Titan isn't really even good against Lycan because you build naturally into Vlads, you naturally build into AC, two items that are great against Natural Order. You have extremely high mobility, making it hard for Echo Stomps to land unless there's a lead-in stun.
Oh, now that is a hero that works against the Lifestealer.
You could also be a disgusting Razor picker. Yes, that hero is very good against Lifestealer. Damage drain is a thing. But if they were going to pick Razor, it actually makes less sense that they ban TA. Because Razor smashes TA in lane. Just completely destroys her. There's nothing you can do. It's one of the hardest counters in the game.
But that is strange then. So you feel... yeah. Huh.
I mean, there still is the argument that TA kills Roshan regardless.
Yeah, for the Rosh potential.
Yeah, the Roshan thing still remains true, but it's kind of a little bit weird just because, like I said, Razor just poops on TA. There's nothing laning-wise that you're going to be able to do about it, even if you get meld. Link stays on anyway.
Yeah, you still lose the
damage.
Yeah,
you don't even need a sentry. It's just, all right, I'm taking your damage. Can't do anything.
Oh. I guess the nice thing about Razor as well, I mean, using it in a game where there's a Shadow Demon and illusions, you got to be careful with those illusions, otherwise you're just going to be feeding free damage and, you know, Razor will just sap, and he'll be able to top himself up to max damage quite a lot. A Death Prophet will be the pick for Secret in the mid lane, so we are going to have this the DP Razor matchup.
It's the double suck lane.
It is.
One sucks damage, one sucks life. I actually still think that Death Prophet has a tiny advantage. Because your base damage is obviously higher, and you're trading taking damage for stealing damage. And in the long run, I think that DP might be able to edge it out. Not to mention her Cryptstorm is a much lower cooldown than Plasma Field, and probably more mana efficient in regards to spamming out the wave. So maybe a slight favor there. Ehome, though, going for the Nyx. It's a very interesting choice. I don't think the Nyx is particularly good against Lifestealer, but it is good against Shadow Demon, and it's fairly good against Death Prophet. So they obviously have something else in mind for what this hero is meant to accomplish. I think what Ehome like is actually just having one hero that gives vision.
Oh. Aye.
That's an offlane Lifestealer.
Is that an offlane Lifestealer?
Yeah, it is.
Is that an offlane Lifestealer?
It looks like it is for sure. And with Nyx being picked and Team Secret... Okay, so Team Secret recognize that this is going to be a very easy laning phase for the Drow. A very easy laning phase. And giving the bonus damage to the Death Prophet versus the Razor might tip the scales for the lane of the Death Prophet just a little bit more.
Oh man.
And also knowing that since it's most likely going to be an old 11 Nyx, that Kunkka alone with a Razor, you might be able to kill the Death Prophet, but it's going to be tricky. And then Keeper of the Light, you might have to rotate as well. Whereas I think they really want to try to get stacks in the early game just to be a little bit more greedy. But we'll see. I think Team Secret right now might have an edge here. I like their draft quite a bit more than
so who goes to the lane with Lifestealer? Is it going to be the fifth pick? Or?
It could be the fifth pick. It could also be something that Team Secret are willing to change on the fly.
Yeah.
So if they decide, all right, you know, a Nyx lane against a Drow, the Drow is going to be more than fine. Like, Nyx is never going to really threaten a Drow. And I think that's fine. Same thing could be said for Lifestealer. So regardless of whether the Drow goes top or bottom, you're probably just going to want to give her the technical safer lane, which is always going to be top. And then it's just going to be Lifestealer off with whatever. And the other thing, too, is Lifestealer is a super fast jungler with Iron Talon, too. Can't forget that. So even in the case that his lane is hard, he just goes and hits jungle creeps.
It's a final pick now for Secret. Looking for that.
Wait. What if they just jungle the lifestealer from the start and pick something else that goes off lane?
What if they have puppy play lifestealer? Yeah, and do the puppy jungle. 5 seconds remaining. Why would he ban out the Chen?
Oh god, well because maybe they just don't expect it. Why did they ban TA?
It's the puppy Chen, so they were on the right lines banning out the Chen.
Yeah.
But the Enchantress is going to be what Puppy settles for.
They recognize that their heroes are really bad against junglers. Like, Hoddle sucks against Chen, Kanka sucks against Chen, Razor and Nyx both suck against Chen. It's a very good call from Secret to pick up that Enchantress. It would have been cool, though, to see some crazy stuff. I guess you can't really pick anything like Batrider because there's already Nyx on the field. Because I thought maybe if you had Bat in the offlane and then Lifestealer jungle, it puts so much pressure on Ehome in the lanes that they need to, like, they need to do the same stuff they did in the previous game, but their lineup isn't nearly as good at it. They don't have that Night Stalker or anything like that. So now we're looking at potentially Ice and his hero.
And we have still got, what's still there? There's still the Juggernaut.
Yeah,
Juggernaut's still there.
And I'm not entirely sold, but it's kind of one of the best choices just by virtue of, like, Slark, Void, and AM all being banned.
Is there any chance of a... what's going on here? So it's Ice, Timbersaw, safe lane.
Yeah, it's Timber safe.
And you're doing this to what? Deal with the Lifestealer in your offlane to make it life hard for Bulba, or...?
They might be... Yeah, I mean, it's good. It's good against Lifestealer in lane. That is very true. I just thought they might want something that has a little bit more potential and push. Like, what hero on this team hits buildings? Ehome! How are you going to kill towers?
Razor builds an axe?
I guess.
That is it.
I don't actually see how Ehome hit a single building.
Refresh a Vendetta hit on the Nyx assassin.
If Vendetta doesn't hit towers. If it did, that would actually be imbalanced.
God damn it, Ehome. They should have known this.
New Aghanim's Vendetta now hits towers.
But double damage.
Oh my Jesus. You would like one-shot a tower at level 16 with Aghs.
Wow. Sounds like a Terrorblade.
Yeah, pretty much. Except Terrorblade does that with no Aghanims at level 7.
Yes. Level 7.
I don't know about
true.
This. I'm really skeptical about Ehome's draft this game.
Oh, time of first tower destruction. Wow, I've got to be precise with this one. My goodness. Well, 8 minutes to 11, of course. Everyone's going to die. Everyone's. Yes, that's actually...
I have some amount of physical damage? Okay.
Is 1,000 possible this game? Yeah, Kunkka's going to get double Daedalus.
The support conk is going to get double Daedalus. All right, boys, we're in.
Dude, I'm done with these predictions. They're just annoying. Highest magic damage, Lifestealer. Lol.
Got him.
My prediction points are secured. If you haven't followed mine, you're an idiot. All right, here we have it. Secret versus Ehome game 2. And quite some stuff indeed. Name-wise, it does look to be exactly what we expected. I mean, can we expect to see Puppy aggressively moving around the jungle of Ehome and being there in the neighborhood of Bulba, or will they just leave Bulba on his own to drop?
Oh, God, the dual offlane would just crush Ehome in the early game.
That's the plan.
Because the thing is, killing the Nyx isn't super valuable if the Nyx isn't contesting the lane. And I don't think that he's going to be contesting the lane against SD and a Drow. Or if they, you know, they put the Drow mid instead or whatever. It doesn't matter. Like, the Nyx in the lane is not scary. That's not what you worry about. You worry about when he hits 6 or 7 and he has Arcane Boots and he's running around the map in Vendetta looking for picks. That's when the hero becomes scary. But either way, I am, like, heavily favoring Secret's draft this game. The battle begins. I mean, maybe Ehome can pull out some clutch plays. You know, they had to play a similar style of Dota in Game 1 and they did it and they executed well, so maybe they'll do it again here in Game 2.
Let's look at the laning indeed. It is going to be, what, Ice Timber up against the Bulba Lifestealer. Mid lane, old 11 on the Nyx assassin mid. They're gonna put him mid against Envy's Death Prophet.
And they're gonna aggro with the Razor, yeah.
Absolutely.
This makes much more sense than putting the Razor mid, because I don't even. I mean, old 11's not gonna have a very good time mid, but he certainly wouldn't have a good time in the offlane. And this is something that when teams first started picking Nyx, they would do is they would prioritize giving the Nyx experience, and then as soon as the Nyx gets the arcanes and his levels, he just leaves the lane forever, and then somebody else rotates in to take the farm. That being said, I'm still not sold that this is really going to matter too much, but we will see.
I mean, can Ehome get kills on this top lane?
They can get kills at level 2.
Level 2, they can.
Yeah, the Kunkka needs a second spell. Or third spell, whichever. Knowing Lanham, he'll probably just skill Tidebringer instead of X, but...
I'll send him an envy.
Man, all 11's going in.
I was going to say, this is what the hell's going on. 7 for 4 against 2 for 0. Old 11 Nyx Assassin. It's doing it. It really is an envy.
He's got
having trouble.
Aura. How is he losing so bad?
He needs Metamorphosis Aura.
I mean, I know that mana burn is really annoying, because eventually you're not going to have enough mana to Spirit Siphon and whatnot, but your base damage is just straight up higher than his.
A slow start for Envy. We'll see if he's able to recover. Obviously, once there's a few points in the Crypt Swarm, he may have a better time in the lane. But all 11, he's going to have a great start this game.
Yeah, but the aggro tri-lane actually forces the attention of Puppy to be top, and this is something that's good for Ehome, because as long as Puppy's not moving around the map, just being a nuisance to the other supports, or excuse me, the other solo laners, then that's pretty much job done from the aggro try. It's not necessarily about shutting down the farm of the hero so much, even though as it stands right now, Artur is only 3-3, the Razor's 5-7, so they're controlling the lane in addition to locking Puppy into one position on the map where he can't really go anywhere and make something happen.
Bubble's doing well down here. I can see the CS at the moment, keeping it level with the Timbersaw. So not yet at the point where Ice is able to entirely harass Bulver out of the lane, and the farm will be there for the Lifestealer in this early laning stage. But as we can see now, okay, gets the point. Level 3, you're just being able to warp forward with the reactive armor, not worrying about any kind of damage coming back onto you, and will now force Bubble to use the salve. But Bubble did at least get a bit of a good start to the lane, and has a bit of farm already. In the mid lane, Envy now starting to catch back up a bit, but old 11 just continue to maintain the lead, and as you said, just taking that mana away from the Death Prophet, making sure that Envy's going to be totally reliant on the right clicks. No chance of crypt swarming to clean the waves out here.
I'm just like amazed that old 11 is doing just like, he's doubling his CS and quadrupling his denies. This guy's just a beast.
And as you said, you know, if this Nyx Assassin has a good time, this is gonna have an absolute knock-on effect for the other lanes as he starts to make rotations with his level 6.
I might have to talk to some mid players and actually ask them how this is supposed to go, because maybe my recollection of the matchup is not correct. Oh, Artur top lane got torrented here.
Once you're concealing a fair bit of damage, plus 28. I mean, this is a lane, the CSY is what we were saying, so 12 for 9 for Artur. It's having an edge against Old Chicken. No bottom lane, Bulba. Still keeping very close to Ice's farm. Ice with the slight edge. Still no one to fool yet. Mid lane. Old 11. He's gonna force Envy to head top, and Envy is gonna find the regen rune the Puppy just spots out.
That's a huge rune for him.
Absolutely. Especially with the situation with the mana burn coming through constantly from the Nyx Assassin.
Yeah.
Bounty rune, it's gonna pop old 11 very close to the level 6. So he will have that. We'll see if he's able to catch anyone out. Maybe even make a play in the mid lane on Envy if he's able to outplay him.
Yeah, these lanes going very well right now for Ehome. The only one that's kind of sketch is top, and it's only because Artur is currently leading in CS over the Razor. But again, as long as Puppy is being forced to stay up here and he's not really getting a ton or making any rotations that are helping a lane, then I think it's still okay. And of course, Ice is he's slightly leading over Bulbul. Not like a huge amount, just it's decent.
Yeah, this is really
top lane again.
That Bulba is finding at least something. You know, yeah, obviously with this pressure as well, they managed to take about a third of the tail for the tower. So a couple more of these pushes and they'll be able to push down the safe lane of secret. I mean, Puppy, as you said, his presence was needed in the lane. He's now managed to come over into the jungle, get a few levels himself, and he's going to go for a smoke movement. And see if he can do anything about mid lane.
Oh, this is really good timing. He's just about to hit 6. And he wasted Carapace, so if they go on him with Ghosts, they should be able to kill. Assuming the Nyx doesn't have mana for ulti.
And it looks like he will, just in time. Oh no, not with the mana burn use. He's got 2 bottle charges. But indeed, they could make the move beforehand. And she's just going to head straight behind Puppy, make sure there's nothing else around. The stun control is there now with the Siphon.
One
that
mana,
move in.
One
this
mana.
Could be a big kill, but they don't have detection.
Ooh, that was close.
So all 11's out.
Infuse Raindrop, MVP. Gave him the mana regeneration he needed.
And a bounty.
Wait, what?
Saber? Is he working for the enemy?
He just like walked into the room.
Oh, he thought he could save it for Envy. And Paul was like, hey, Envy, there's a rune down here. Whoa. And Envy's like, you kidding me, mate? There's nothing there. And look, oh, 11. Look, I'll take both. Two runes for the man.
Oh my god.
Easy runes.
And he's going to go top and look for a kill. This guy is just...
has he got any chance of finding it?
I don't know if he can... Oh, there's no untouchable on Puppy.
Oh.
But he only has enough mana for a stun. Yeah, he's just going to go drop the ward.
Yeah.
That's good stuff. Wow, is he actually not going to get spotted at all? The ward sees Puppy, but that's a hard kill without Vendetta. Yeah, he's probably just going to back up.
He's going to look back towards mid lane. I mean, he's got the backup of Fenrir and Old Lanham coming in. Old Lanham. Maybe thinking about going for a blind torrent. Well, he's picked himself off phase boots on this bottom lane. Level 6 as well, so the Lifestealer's progress still going very well for an offlane Lifestealer. Rages, turns around, thinks about punching into Ice, but at this point there's going to be not nearly enough damage for that. Vendetta from all 11, but Puppy did have the little rock golems out, so I think they'll know that he's up to something. He's going to make a beeline straight towards top lane, but Puppy has laid down the sentry there, expecting this movement from all 11. We'll see what they can do about it. Holding him back with the disruption, but that is what they're going to have to pull him back. They're going to be fortunate that Old 11 doesn't decide to proceed for more, just turns towards the creep and takes it from Puppy's army. As we can see CS-wise, it's looking very much favorable for the side of Ehome.
I mean, a Seeker can still fight around Ghosts, and it's not necessarily a bad thing, but Ehome really needed these lanes to go well for the lineup to succeed, again, similar to their first game draft, and they're getting what they want. So the Timber has a ton of farm. The Nyx is beating the Drow or a Death Prophet. And, you know, the Razor's not really ahead of the Drow, but...
Oh, look at Ice. He's ready to look for some styling plays on Bulba, but Bulba infests in and out. Ice will back away. He's forced a couple of TPs from Secret down here. So they're actually able to kill him. Envy's come around as well. But yeah, Ice is fine. They can't kill this Timbersaw. Fenrir's there as well to back him up in case anything was going to occur. And all 11. Looking to use this chance. They know that there's been movement from Secret down and out. Moving in onto RTZ, the Vendetta into the stun. Old Chick is there as well, and Artur, he needs some help. He's got Puppy. Is it going to be enough? Looking to focus on Old Chick and forcing them back, and that's going to allow RTZ to stay alive. Bulba with the TP, going into Old Chick, tries for a very bold TP, and it's going to be punished. Secret reacting very nicely to Ehome's play on the top lane and finding themselves first blood.
Yeah, that was a really nice reaction coming in from Sam. He just immediately TPs as soon as that dive comes in. Gets a super valuable kill on the Razor. And this first and second Vendettas, actually no, sorry, first three Vendettas have not really accomplished anything. I mean, yeah, it's not the longest cooldown spell, it's only 70 seconds, but if you're old 11...
Envy? He run away, sir.
He did.
Alright, well... He had good intentions, I'm sure.
He did. And unfortunately, the only hero that was in the area from Ehome prior to the TPs was the Nyx, and he was in this. Plus, the ward wouldn't have seen him anyway because he TP'd to the tower, and that ward does not grant vision that far. So that was a super unfortunate position to be in, if you're Envy. And as we talked about, the Nyx rotations do allow Lanham to get that level 6. Kind of has his boat ready to go at 10-minute mark.
And of course, we've seen how much Lanham can do on this Kunkka. Especially once he gets the phase drums armlet built up. Old 11 bottles up a double damage. 20 seconds before Vendetta again, and we can expect to see him go for another play. Keeping the activity high across the map. Top lane, Ice putting on the pressure. And looking towards the bottom, Pi. Eyes onto Old Chicken. Has the backup of Bulba if they want to try and set up for a play. Old Lanham is going to be spotted out by Envy. Envy's going to start to chase him down. Old Lanham should be able to play his way out of this one. Envy himself needs to be careful. Oh, there's a double damage Nyx Assassin. Here we go. One touch and the burst. The nuke damage bringing him below the torrent to follow through, and they're going to be able to take down Envy again. Envy to fall. LTZ and Bulba moving in onto Old Chicken, but the damage being taken. Bulba can't continue to fight. They really want to kill the Razor, but they can't. LTZ can't quite finish him off. Oh, and then the two-man stun. The torrent. Here comes the Illuminate. Ice finishing 1-2-3 off with the Chakram, and Bulba. He's got to run. He's got to hide. Old 11. Can he chase this down? Looks like Bulba will be able to get himself out of there, but Secret losing 3 in a very, very messy altercation in Ehome's jungle.
Man, I don't think the fighting is ever the play there when you already have your Death Prophet dead. That was... I mean, sure, they got caught out by the Nyx carapace and the double stun or whatever, but as soon as they knew that Envy was dead, they should have just bailed. Like, there's no way you fight without ghosts. Secret in a very precarious situation here. Not doing very well in the lanes. The first couple of altercations, barring the TP reaction top, have not gone well for them. They lost their tier 1 in the safe lane. They've lost Envy multiple times now. And this is a guy who wasn't even winning his lane in the first place. They need to either get some objectives or take their foot off the gas a bit and try to farm it up. Because, I mean, up until this point, Puppy's like not even level 6. It's 12 minutes in.
Ask for the Midas recipe. So if they are obviously able to draw this one out, they will be able to eventually catch up, but it is going to take a lot of time.
I mean, I just don't know what Envy was doing there. Like, he was sitting in the middle of Ehome's woods, like, looking for some kind of kill. And you know there's a Nyx in the game. Old 11 just seems to be the player in this series so far.
And he spotted out Bulba. Let's see how they can start this one off. I'm not going to quite go for it as of yet.
He's a really hard target. He needs to stun like super fast, otherwise Bulba just rages.
They need to get they need a Torrent follow, but at the moment all the Kunkka's on the top lane, so
yeah,
they don't have anything to follow for the initial stun from all 11. Vendetta's actually going to run out fairly soon. They'll see that there's a couple of ancient stacks and makes the move across, but Sentry is there. They'll spot out the Nyx. Yeah, indeed, the pings are coming out, but all 11's fine. He'll back off onto his half of the map. Old Lanham is getting a hell of a lot of space this game. I'm going to go for the drums after the phase. We'll go straight for that armlet. Poppy finishes off Midas at the same time.
Old Lanham is actually like the hidden carry.
He's a bit of a mastermind on the Kunkka.
He just says, all right, Old 11, it's my turn to get farm. Now you go slay people on the bug, man.
And again, it's this issue. Look at the farm. It's...
Yeah,
Ehome
it's insane.
Have just done... They're just doing so much better than Secret in these laning stages. We saw it in game 1 and we're seeing it again here in game 2.
I mean, I'm not sure about the mid-match stuff. I still feel like it shouldn't have been that lopsided. But, you know, especially with Drow Aura. I did figure that top lane would be pressured, but, you know, at the end of the day, the Razor and the Drow are still even.
What do you think about this as well, this bot's first Razor?
Seen it before.
Yeah.
Envy himself actually did that build. After you do like pretty okay in your lane, you go for the bots and then you just... It's really nice for running at people when you have static link, and it also allows you to be at fights because Razor really wants to be involved. But one of the biggest issues with the hero is his inability to flash farm. But having bots supplements that and your teamfight capability by just being faster.
Well, Levin tried to set up there, was off the mark with the stun. Wasn't able to connect onto Bulba.
I mean, this game has kind of slowed down, but just by virtue of Secret feeling uncomfortable taking fights. It's very, very tough. Like, Ice is... He is very far ahead right now.
Dude, he is insane. 6.3k. I mean, Ice, obviously the carry role now. Back in the day, Timbersaw was his hero, and he's showing us that he can still be. Envy's come up, but there's a sentry ward here, and they'll start it off. The silence comes a little too late. It's not going to cancel the torrent. Envy, he needs backup and he needs it now. Within the mana to Ice, he'll move across. Old Lemon's going to look for the wraparound. The torrent again connects. Envy will be taken down. The ball onto Pi. Oh my goodness, the Kunkka. Doing work here for Ehome. The man himself, Old Lanham. We saw it game 1, we're seeing it again in game 2. Just perfect play, and Secret just don't seem to know how to deal with it.
God, this is just brutal. Secret are getting caught all over the map. That's the third death for Envy in a row? Like, he hasn't even been involved in a kill.
Just look at the net worth. The top 4 highest all on the side of Ehome.
It's just honestly Ehome outplaying them every step of the way. It's like Old 11 is always in the right spot at the right time. Lanham's been on point with the boat torrents. They're just never where they need to be on the side of Secret. They're just getting caught out of position over and over again. At some point, you know, you got to group up and try to fight. Otherwise, you're just going to get ran over by the Nyx. He's just been finding way too much. I mean, now he even has Blink. The guy hasn't really hit creep since the laning phase. As when he hit 6.
Oh, Chicken, he is on his own. TP's will be coming through. We'll see what he can do to react to this one. Goes for the Stanley Link of Bulba, but he goes around and Old Chicken will fall. This time, Secret finds something. Ehome unable to do anything in return. Old Lanham. X marks himself back out. The Secret get a pick. I'm gonna try and turn it to 2 on push, but at the same time, Arteezy's been left behind. Old 11 and Ice surround him. He'll find the kill still. Oh, the boat again onto Envy, but the ghost around, he's gonna have the heal going back up. Old Lanham turns around, looks for the Tidebringer hit. Secret moving in as 4. Fenrir, they need to do something to help him. The mana leak on Bulbul will hold him back. Old Lanham escapes. Torrent onto Envy. Now the TP reactions from Ehome coming through. Let's see if they can actually find anything. Oh, Puppy! He takes down the Admiral. And he's gonna play around with Fenrir. Hello!
I mean, they're losing their backline, so.
This is, I'm watching this 1v1. It's good fun.
He's gonna die.
Yeah.
He doesn't have a TP. At least get to the camp to Midas. Run to the camp to Midas!
Oh!
No, he got it.
What? Right.
He got it.
He got it.
By the way, when Lanham got punched in the face, he had a 17 charge wand and an armlet and just didn't use either of them. He just got punched. Oh god, this game. Man, how did it go so bad for Secret? It just everything fell apart. The irony is, the one lane that Ehome sent up there to the top, you know, three heroes really wanted to pressure, that was a lane that did the best. That was a lane where the Drow was still getting as much farm as the Razor. And both the mid and the bottom lane just got destroyed. I mean, the Timber versus Lifestealer matchup, I kind of get.
Yeah, this is, I mean, again, this is Secret being forced into a similar position that they were in game one. But this time they don't have an Arteezy Morphling to split the team up.
Remind me not to underestimate Ehome's capability of executing a draft. Next time I doubt them, you just shake me like a baby and tell me no.
I mean, see, what is the game plan here for Secret to stop Eho? Because Eho are just absolutely playing out their minds this series.
Your guess is as good as mine. They just, honestly, they need to stop dying in fights. Like, stop solo getting picked off. Stop giving opportunities for Old 11 to find these pickoffs. That's really what set the ball rolling for Eho. As soon as the laning phase breaks down and that Nyx starts moving, they really want this stack too. I'm trying to contest it as best they can. They're even pulling in more heroes. All 11's in a perfect spot as well.
There's a sentry to the left. He's not going to wander under it. Ice, he's going to be on to cook up the fight. Comes across, all 11 jumps in with a 2-man stun. Arteezy and Envy caught out. Torrent to follow through. Is he going to connect with Arteezy? He's already dead. There's the boat into the face of Envy, smashing his head in. And now they're moving for more. Ice, eyes on the pylon die, chopping the Shadow Demon to bits. It's the third death on Secret. The Torrent's there again. Bulba beats the hell out of it. Secret losing 4 and Ehome with no mercy whatsoever. And Old 11, he doesn't do it. If he finishes off the team.
No, he can't. There's no way. He has 40 health.
Oh my goodness. It's a team wipe, effectively.
I didn't know Ice had bots. That helps.
Oh, okay.
Jeez.
Wow.
That's a 20 charge Bloodstone Timber at 19 minutes.
That's not bad.
Ehome heard me say that I didn't like their draft.
Dude, this Timber's so rich. Ice.
I didn't know he had bots. He just goes in and then all of a sudden dead edge. Oh. Jesus Christ. This is a thwomping.
Ooh. Envy. Hello.
Envy.
Not the dream, but okay, that might just be. But Ice has been silenced in the middle of it all, trying to bring down Pine. He does, chops him down. Ice. What's our secret? Still trying to fight into this puppy. Looking for Old Lanham. Rage from Pulver, but the blink away from Old. Old Evan, here we go. Silence on Ice. Can they bring down the Timber, the Torrent, holding the back? Let's kill himself.
Instant respawn. He's coming back.
He's ready to bolt straight right through. Secret looking to do as much as they can with the ghosts. Envy, who's he going to look for? Trying to chase down Old Lanham. Old Lanham says, come for me. And Envy says, no. And now he is trapped in the creeps. And Old 11 is going to be there to cut him off. Envy says, team, don't leave me behind. Arteezy says, screw you, mate.
GG.
Why?
God.
Well,
we're gonna have to just put a disclaimer on the stream and just have this be rated like NC-17, no minors allowed, because I'm pretty sure this is illegal in like multiple countries.
Yeah, it is. Believe me, I know.
Everything for Secret went wrong this game. Like all of Envy's movement.